Let us start the derivation of mirror equation, and for this first we understand how the ray diagram is drawn for the concave mirror. This is a concave mirror. There are some rules for the ray diagram. It was in class 10th. So I will revise once again what is the rules to draw the ray diagram. This is the pole of the mirror. This is the center of the mirror. That is the center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. This is the focus, half of the center of curvature, or radius of curvature. If the light ray is coming parallel to principal axis, if the light ray is coming parallel to principal axis, it always passes through focus. The first is, if the light ray is coming parallel to principal axis, after reflection it will pass through focus. अगर कोई लाइट प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस के पैरेलल आती है तो रिफ्लेक्शन के बाद फोकस से गुजरेगी. ये पहला रूल है. दिस फर्स्ट रूल. सेकंड, इफ द लाइट रे इज पासिंग थ्रू फोकस, द लाइट इज पासिंग थ्रू फोकस, इट बिकम पैरेलल टू प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस. इट विल बिकम पैरेलल टू प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस. अगर कोई लाइट रे फोकस से जा रही है तो रिफ्लेक्शन के बाद प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस के पैरेलल हो जाएगी. ये प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस है, ये इसके पैरेलल हो जाएगी. एंड द थर्ड इज, if the light ray is passing through C, if the light ray is passing through C, it will retrace its path. वो अपने रास्ते से वापस चली जाएगी. If the light ray is passing through C, it will pass through the same path, that is retrace its path. So there are three rays. First is the light ray parallel to principal axis, pass through focus. The second one is the light ray passing through focus, become parallel after reflection. And the third is, this is the third ray, if it is passed through center of curvature, it will retrace its path. So while drawing the ray diagram, we can take any of the two or we can take three, but it is a suggestion that we take only two rays to draw the ray diagram. For the derivation of mirror equation, I am taking the help of NCERT diagram. This is the figure number 9.5. As you see in this figure, this is the object AB. This is the object, and they had taken three rays to draw the ray diagram. You see the first ray is originating from the A point, and the light ray is going parallel to principal axis and passing through focus. First ray is passing through focus because it is parallel to principal axis. The second one, the light ray is going to the pole of the mirror, and after reflection it passes from this side. If you see that this is a C, and if you draw a line from C to anywhere, it will always perpendicular to the tangent drawn. That's why it is taken as a normal. So if this light ray coming from point A to P, this is angle of incidence and the same angle of reflection is there because law of reflection follows everywhere. And this is the third line. The light ray is passing through C, retrace its path. You see the direction of arrows. The light ray is coming, and this is the light ray is retracing its path. You see the direction of the arrow here also. So this is a diagram of a concave mirror to derive the mirror equation. And if you see the symbols from P to F, this is the focal length, F, small f. From P to B dash, this is the image, the distance of image from the pole is V, and this is the object P to B. This is the object distance taken as U. U, V and F, mirror equation is the relation between U, V and F, what we are going to derive here with the help of this diagram. And let us derive the mirror equation, and for your convenience I have drawn the diagram here with the two rays only. In the book I have shown you that there are three rays, but we are taking two rays here. One ray is parallel to principal axis, and again I am saying that these are the paraxial rays, because the ray which is reflection after reflection passing through focus, they are called paraxial rays. So that's why I am not taking this term every time, but in this diagram I am making it clear that I am taking the paraxial rays only. Means this ray is very close to principal axis, but for the sake of convenience I have shown there is some gap between the paraxial rays and the principal axis. So this is parallel to principal axis, passing through focus, called paraxial rays. And the second one I have taken, that passing through C and retracing its path. Now, You make the diagram, make everything very clear. This is the focus from pole, the distance of focus is F, focal length. From pole to image distance, it is taken as V. And from pole to object distance, I am taking it as U. So mirror equation is relation between U, V and F. This is the relation we are going to find between these terms. The term U is object distance from pole, V image distance from pole, and F is focus distance from P, that is focal length. If you see in the diagram, there are two triangles, two right angle triangles are there. Two right angle triangles are there. Two right angle triangles. One is A dash, B dash and F. A dash, B dash and F. This is the right angle triangle. A dash, B dash, F. And the second one is MPF. Because this is very close, that's why I am taking it as a straight line M, P and F. So two right angles triangles are there. Two right angle triangles are there. One is this and other is this right angle triangle. And both are similar. These two triangles, both are similar. And I know that everyone knows about the property of similarity. That's why I'm not going to discuss what is similarity. But these two triangles are similar. You can see right angle and this angle also equal. Two angles are equal. That's why they are similar. So now we are going to use the similarity concept in two triangles. B dash, A dash. B dash A dash upon PM. PM. B dash A dash upon PM is equal to B dash F upon FP. B dash F upon FP. The ratio, corresponding ratios are equal. This is the property of similarity. Or B dash A upon B A is equal to B dash F upon F P, because PM I taken equal to AB. PM is equal to AB. That's why B dash A dash upon PM is equal to B dash F upon FP, or B dash A upon BA is equal to B dash F upon FP. What I have done, I have replaced BM to AB. You see from here, because PM is equal to AB, that's why PM upon PM and BA are same thing. Now I had drawn the third ray from A to P, and then after reflection it is passing through this point. This is the third ray I had drawn. Now we are seeing the triangle again here, and the angle are APB. APB is equal to angle A dash P and B dash. APB and A dash P and B dash. These two angles are there, and the right angle triangles a dash, b dash, p, and a, b, p are similar. If anyone forgetting that how to find the similar triangle, so we can revise it here again. In the first case, if you see, we had taken the triangle A dash, B dash, and F, and M, P, F. So you see that this is a right angle, this is a right angle, and this is also, I can take it, a right angle. These two angles are vertically opposite angle, vertically opposite angles are equal, and two right angles are equal. That's why this triangle is similar. So angle APB, APB, APB. APB, one angle is this, and A dash, A dash, P and B dash, this angle. These two angles are equal, and triangle A dash, triangle A dash, B dash, A dash, B dash, and P with this triangle is right angle triangle. This is 90 degree angle, and A, P, B, this is a right angle. So two right angles are two right angles and one angles are equal. So by angle-angle corollary, by angle-angle corollary, the triangles are similar. These triangles are similar. So again applying the similarity property, B dash, A dash upon BA is equal to B dash P upon BP. I can write the number of this equation, equation number 1, and this equation number 2. If you compare both the equation, on comparing equation 1 and 2, अगर हम दोनों क्वेश्चन कंपेयर करें तो क्या मिलेगा हमें, बी डैश एफ अपॉन एफ पी इज इक्वल टू बी डैश पी माइनस एफ पी अपॉन एफ पी. बी डैश एफ अपॉन एफ पी, बी डैश एफ अपॉन एफ पी हमने यहाँ लिया. तो B डैश F को हम क्या लिख सकते हैं, डायग्राम देखें एक बार. B डैश F को क्या लिख सकते हैं, B डैश F को लिख सकते हैं B डैश P माइनस एफ पी. B डैश P में से अगर हम एफ पी को माइनस करेंगे तो इतना ही बचेगा, तो B डैश F की जगह पर लिख सकते हैं B डैश P माइनस एफ पी. तो बी डैश एफ की जगह लिख सकते हैं बी डैश पी माइनस एफ पी अपॉन एफ पी, और ये किसके बराबर है, इट इज इक्वल टू बी डैश पी अपॉन बी पी, इट इज इक्वल टू बी डैश पी अपॉन बी पी. ठीक है, सी फ्रॉम हियर, बी डैश एफ अपॉन एफ पी, B dash F upon FP is equal to B dash A dash upon PM, and PM is equal to AB. So we had changed B dash A upon BA, in place of PM I written BA, and it is equal to B dash F upon FP. This is equation number 1. In equation 1 I forgot to push dash here, so you can change this. B dash A dash upon BA is equal to B dash F upon FP. Now if you see here, B dash F upon FP को हम लिख सकते हैं B dash P minus FP upon FP, and this is equal to b dash a dash upon ba, b dash a dash upon ba को हम लिख सकते हैं b dash p upon bp equation number 2 के हिसाब से. तो हमारी पूरी value b dash f upon fp जिसको हमने चेंज कर लिया है b dash p minus fp upon fp में, ये बराबर हो जाएगा b dash p upon bp के. This is the third equation after comparing equation number 1 and 1 and 2 को compare करके हमने equation number 3 बनाई. Now what we have to do next, again see your diagram. In diagram what is BP, sorry B dash P, B dash P को क्या लिख सकते हैं, B dash P को लिख सकते हैं V, image distance this is V, and remember once again the sign convention, we are measuring the distance from pole, that's why what the V is there, V has minus sign. माइनस बी इन द प्लेस ऑफ बी डैश पी हम लिख सकते हैं माइनस बी. अगेन एफ पी, एफ पी माइनस साइन पुट कर ले यहाँ पे, ये वाला माइनस साइन हमने यहाँ रखा माइनस. और व्हाट इज एफ पी इफ यू सी डायग्राम अगेन, एफ पी, एफ पी इज द डिस्टेंस ऑफ फोकस फ्रॉम द पोल. तो दिस इज एफ फोकल लेंथ, वी आर मेजरिंग अपोजिट टू द लाइट रे कमिंग, तो दिस इज विल बी in negative, again minus f, in place of fp I written minus f upon minus f, fp minus f. And b dash p, again you see the diagram, b dash p is again minus v, and bp, BP, what is BP, P to P, this is object distance and it is minus U. With the help of sign convention, with the help of sign using that, I had taken all the values, minus V, minus, minus F upon minus F is equal to minus V upon U. Now, we can write minus V, minus minus plus, plus F upon minus f is equal to minus v upon minus u. Now what we can do, so minus v plus f upon minus f is equal to minus v upon minus u ko hum change kar sakte hain, minus v upon minus f plus minus minus f upon f is equal to minus v upon u, or we can write it minus v upon minus f minus 1 is equal to minus v upon minus u. Minus v upon minus f minus 1 is equal to minus v upon minus u को हम लिख सकते हैं v upon f minus 1 is equal to v upon u. कभी कभी टीचर आते हैं कि माइनस माइनस कट जाता है, कभी साइन कटते नहीं है, ये अपने आप पॉजिटिव हो जाता है. वी अपॉन एफ माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू वी अपॉन यू, इसको लिख सकते हैं ऐसा. अगेन वी अपॉन एफ इज इक्वल टू वी अपॉन यू प्लस वन, और वन अपॉन एफ इज इक्वल टू वी अपॉन वी यू प्लस वन अपॉन वी, और वन अपॉन एफ वी से भी कैंसिल, वन अपॉन एफ इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन यू प्लस वन अपॉन वी. दिस इज द मिरर इक्वेशन, रिलेशन बिटवीन एफ यू एंड वी, दिस इज द मिरर इक्वेशन.